that's in the waters is throwing it into a frenzy, and as it jumps onto the mud, it starts to sort of whip its head left, right, and center. And the worm gets torn apart for 11 piercing damage.
I really like the name you gave it.
As it becomes Longshore's turn.
Well, it is a really big shark, if that's to scale with our icons.
Fucking huge! How long is it? Oh my god, that's like a 35-foot shark. Christ!
As I swim away, I'm going to drop my pants and aggressively shit behind me. Like an ink screen through which I can escape.
That actually is not...
That's what?
That's not a bad idea. If you're gross and sickly, the thing might not buy you.
Yeah, so I'm just making a shit screen.
Fuck, am I really in my mouth
and like all dissolved, so if the shark has to pick a target, can I be counted as gross and sickly?
Well, your leg's back, you just don't have any pants on that and your shoes gone.
You're just some gross hobo.
Okay, is that it? Alright, so that's the end of Longshore. Alright, the worm tries to fight back onto the shark, but it's not gonna get very far, I don't think. Oh, actually, it does. It bites onto the shark's fins, and you see it rip away a little chunk of it. Just a tiny little bit of it, as it becomes Thorin's turn.
Am I really gonna fucking try and do this as well?
Bite the shark?
No, do a Longshore bid. This is not a bad idea, as fucking retarded as it seems.
You have to, like, grapple with your heavy armor pants, though.
Yeah, no,
it takes
not...
time to take your armor off.
You don't have a pooping hatch? Most armor did.
No, it didn't. Like, most armor didn't.
Shit.
That's the whole thing. Yeah, most armor didn't have that. You, like, knights would shit in their armor on the battlefield because it was... You couldn't afford to take it off.
Ugh.
Yeah, it was awful. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move 15 feet and put myself between me and my friendlies, and I'm going to take the dodge action, which gives attackers disadvantage on me.
Alright, put a little icon on you so I know.
Is there a little shield icon? Yeah, there is.
Sorry, I didn't mean to do that.
As Tobias's life flashes before his eyes, he thinks of his home country.
That's pretty good. I mean, that's fair enough. Alright, so Thorin, end of your turn after you do the dodge action. Everyone gets propelled another 60 feet in that direction.
Oh god!
I think I just clipped the edge of it.
Well, at least I didn't have to shit myself to make myself a not a tasty treat.
Thor's just befouled completely.
The shark's gonna swim away with the giant worm in tow to avoid the shit screen. As it becomes, you guys effectively get out of combat, so I'm gonna just...
Oh, thank god. I can't believe I'm about to congratulate at how big of a shit that he just took.
Alright, so...
It's one of my famous, might just work.
All of you sort of swim deep into this, cave, and you reappear inside this waterfall-y area at the bottom of, like, some cliffs and whatnot.
How high up is,
About 70 feet up each side.
Okay.
So we all break the surface?
Oh yeah, you all break the surface. There's air in here to breathe.
Alright.
No, that's it. It smells very musty. That's all.
Can we, like, climb up onto the shore here?
I'm gonna pop up and maybe go, FUCK!
everything around here are cliffs that go straight up, pretty much.
Do we have footing, or are we still treading water?
You're sort of treading water.
I don't actually rise to the surface very easily. I'm, like, fighting to get to the surface because of my armor, and I imagine I sink back down pretty quick, so I'm, like, moving at, like, 5 feet.
Can I try and fire a grappling hook while treading water? Like, sort of...
Yeah, I mean...
Let myself sink a bit, paddle up, and as I go up, just... Well, I need 2 hands to fire it.
Yeah, I immediately swim over to a wall because I'm weighing... My heavy armor's weighing.
Oh, yeah, sure, you can do that. Roll a... roll an acrobatics first. For longshore. Oh yeah, yep. Easily able to fire this grappling hook. Where do you fire it?
Up onto the cliff. Where, yeah, up here.
Okay. Could you also roll your attack for me?
Yes. Because I could just completely miss and kill Carlos.
Fair chance of that, actually.
It's just like, hey guys, I'll get this to the top. Oh, sorry.
Claire, it's part of the sacrifice to the seventh.
Thingamabobby.
Oh.
Right into Carlos's mouth.
That's perfect. You feel like the grappling hook sort of lodge onto something at the top of the cliff, and then the rope torts itself.
Alright, I start scaling the wall.
Yeah, roll athletics at advantage.
Thank you, sir.
Hey guys, I'm gonna take a deep breath and push off the wall, immediately sink to the bottom, and then run along the bottom. Get into the longshore.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Wow.
Due to being so wet and covered in pooperino, longshore, you get about halfway up the rope before the poop makes a slide down back into the water.
Like, covers the rope.
No, I'm just kidding. You're not poop covered. You do slide off there.
Well, I'll just try again.
At least you didn't have to worry about falling onto a rope. Yeah.
Tobias starts like chanting as he's bobbing in the water.
Hey, Carlos, babe, come here.
Tobias, what do you say you do? Chanting?
I'm gonna start chanting. Ah. If we can't get out of here in 10 minutes, then I'll just cast the darn his hut, Lehman's tiny hut, and we can just chill out in an air bubble for a bit.
Take just this. 14 healing to you, Carlos.
Oh, thank you, good sir. I actually do need that. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm just gonna try climbing again if I can.
In this case, I'll let you take the take 20. Just nothing's gonna happen if you fail over and over. So sweet. Eventually, you do climb up to the top of it. I assume everyone else also followed.
Yes, please. Yep.
Yeah.
Could Tobias, Thorin, and Carlos roll your initiative to see who goes up first?
I'll go up last.
Oh, you'll go up last?
Yep.
Alright, then in that case, can you roll a perception for me?
Sure.
Shark.
That's why I waited. I'm the one who can tangle with it.
Yeah, so as everyone sort of makes their way up, and Thorin, you eventually get your way to the top, and as you sort of look back down into the water, you see just the tail fin of it. The tail fin of the shark.
This is after I've made it to the top?
Yeah, after you made it to the top.
Okay, cool.
And as everyone sort of gets to the top, you find yourselves... There's like some wooden train tracks and whatnot that lead deeper into a tunnel, and there are three different paths that sort of converge onto the same area. I'm going to move you all to one side because this would be where you would be, so if you don't move yourself, that'd be fair.
Okay.
Alright, so you would be in this sort of complex.
Ooh. That was a very smooth transition, just done.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yep. So you're probably in that complex, and as you sort of start walking along, you see that most of the walls themselves have been mined away, and they're like mine supports, wooden supports all along the tunnels, and there are various tracks leading all over the place.
I don't know about you guys, but I'd like to lie down for a while.
Yeah, I just throw my helmet off and just collapse against the wall. I'm like, Tobias, fucking do that thing.
Yeah, make the plug the
and as thing. All of you start to rest, you just hear sort of like rubble falling to the floor in the distance and various cave ambient noises and whatnot.
That sounds like a tomorrow long show problem. Damn you, Tuesday Bojack.
Yeah, as soon as Tobias is on dry land, he'll start chanting to cast Liamon's tiny hut. And about 10 minutes later, when it appears, as soon as it's up and active, he just like falls onto his bum, rests his back against the side of the dome, and just like puts his head into his palms and just shakes.
This is going to be a short rest or a long rest?
I vote for long.
Yeah,
the dome will only last for an hour.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I thought it lasted 8 hours.
Yeah, me too.
Let me double check. I thought it was.
It's pretty. I'm pretty sure it was 8. 8 hours.
Ah, 8 hours, yeah. Yeah, I'm thinking of a rope trick, sorry. Yeah, so I vote long rest.
Yeah. Agreed.
We need to attune our equipment, you'll get hit dice back.
Alright, whilst everyone is out, I'm gonna be right back.
Oh. Alrighty. We'll handle that shit while you're gone then. Alright, I'm gonna hand out food and water.
Thank you very much. Take it. Consume it ravenously.
I got my own. I'm good. Thank you, bud.
But do you have one of these? I pull out either one of my wineskins. I feel like we could all use a drink after what just happened.
Oh god, yes.
Yeah, and so I'll hand one to Longshore and Carlos, and I'll just plonk down next to Tobias and share one with him as well.
Carlos skulls it.
Leaves nothing.
Oh, look at that. Aiden's got the same mindset. It's just...
Yeah. That's why I let you two go for that one, because I know that Tobias will willingly share it with me.
Okay, so once we realize that we're not going to be able to do this nicely, I pull out a short sword, cut it in half, and then we both have a little cup.
Culture.
So I'm going to jam my blunted longsword in the ground, balance my broken longbow on top of it, and dangle the wineskin from one end, and then just spin it.
Oh, God. So many towns will summer was spent doing that.
Alright.
Everyone manages to take a long rest without being interrupted whatsoever. If you have a ration, please eat one. And you're all refilled of spell slots, health, and half your hit die if you spent any.
Alright.
I'd also like to spend some time like taking out each one of my books and using prestidigitation to do like the equivalent of going over them with a hairdryer and just drying them all out. Is any of that salvageable?
I rub my hands together and I'm like, I can probably do that.
What backpack do you have, by the way?
I have Diplomat's Pack and Scholar's Pack.
Oh, that's a toughie. Because if it was Explorer's Pack, I'd be like, oh yeah, sure, it's waterproof, but... If it's that, roll a 1d20, my friend.
We'll see how much we can save. I can steam it all out.
Do I get any sort of law bard native bonuses to
with an 11 you're able to... with an 11 you're able to salvage all your books, it's fine. They're just wet and maybe some ink here and there might have smudged, but other than that, it's fine.
I'll make copies of them when we're back on dry land.
What's up, Longshore?
Can you repair my stuff, please?
Yeah, I can.
Thank you.
Alright.
And I'll take my short bow back.
Or will you?
Okay, I will ask politely to have my short bow back.
I don't fucking want it, just take it. I throw it off the side of the cliff into the water below.
Fucking rude.
Alright, Mr. DM, am I rolling my smith tools?
To fix Tobias's...
Longshore's gear, the shit that he... Right.
Yeah, please roll smith tools.
Alrighty.
Wait, this is for his bow, right?
And his sword. I want to sharpen the sword and restring his bow.
To restring a bow... fuck it, I'll let it roll on the smith tools. Why not? Yeah, roll them twice. They're pretty good. You managed to do both of that. You fixed both the sword and the bow.
Alright, so I'll wake up like an hour earlier than everybody during the rest. After I finish my my long rest, but yeah, I'll wake up like half an hour to an hour earlier and just wear down a whetstone and spend like 15 minutes fucking tying the string together in the middle and making sure it's still like taut enough to actually be able to be drawn.
I snap my fingers. Does Dog the Cat appear? Or is he in a shark's belly?
What happens when it dies?
Suddenly gets way hungrier.
That's a good question. The spell card doesn't say.
You've got to resummon it.
Okay. I assume I need the scroll for that, though.
Yeah.
You need a scroll, you need a brazier, you need the incense, you need all of that stuff again.
Yeah. So Dog the Cat is no more. He served us well.
Thank God.
Dog the Cat.
Hey, he saved our lives, like, at least twice in the caves.
He actually did.
I agree.
It is
without
true.
Him, the shark would have touched you guys when you were trying to climb up the rope. So he did well.
Oh, even
if this was like
screen.
A TV show, you know, you'd pan out the dog outside swimming away from the shark.
To his horrible master.
Can you just imagine at the end of the campaign, like, Wes brings up a black screen just, like, dedicated to Dog the Cat?
Alright, I have spent some time attuning to my shield of shielding.
Need to work on a better name for that.
Ward of warding. It fits so well to your character.
Yeah, it does. I've got a warded warhammer and I've got my shield of shielding. My dad runs the fucking ward off evil. Hell yeah, it fucking runs in the family.
Do you reckon I could get an arrow through the slits in your visor?
Be right back, guys.
Alrighty.
He actually won't. I'm going to kill him as soon as he opens the door.
So, can we agree never to do that again?
Pardon?
What's that?
Can we agree never to do that again?
Agreed.
Yep. All in favor of never touching any body of water bigger than one glass, say I. Yeah.
Yeah. We're going to have like a Mr. T type phobia of water travel after this.
Yeah. We'll move out into the middle of Vestigard, just somewhere out in the middle of buttfuck nowhere where it's the desert.
Like, is a world with creatures like those worms really worth saving anyway?
Also, we should, like, renegotiate our pay with Kyra when we get back.
Oh god, I'm gonna stab her in the fucking pay? Brain.
Yeah, I was about to say, I don't think we got paid. I'm pretty sure the payment was...
Exactly.
I don't know, I'm still pretty happy with the payment, which is Goethe's doesn't kill everyone any of us know.
Point, but we really should have been informed about... Everything.
Oh yeah, no, don't get me wrong, a strongly worded letter shall be written.
Well, I mean, I don't know about you guys, but everyone I know is the three of you, so...
Wow, what a fucking loser. Wow, I'm so sorry.
Not really the big answer.
Alrighty.
I'm gonna fucking poison your biscuit.
Alright, so long sure as you wake up, I hand you back your sword and your bow, and I say they should work fine. Once we get back to town, I should be able to fix the bow up properly, but it should do well for now.
Sick.
Hopefully it survives a couple dozen pulls, but we'll have to see how it goes.
I test fire on Tobias.
Tobias dies, I guess. You deal like twice my health pool in damage reliably, so...
I could one-shot myself with some of these.
Man, my shield of shielding's awesome. I can give someone +5 AC as a reaction.
Oh, it's not just you?
No, it's anybody.
Ooh.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that what I wrote?
Yeah.
Let me double check that.
I think so. I remember seeing it had a range of 30 feet. Oh no, it is just me. Never mind. Maybe someone else should... Tobias, this might actually be better for you.
Just sling it off his back.
Give me a while and I can cast shield on my own 4 times a day, so...
Fair enough, but
yeah.
I'm a big tanky boy. Oh, by the way, I totally put on that plate.
You keep the shield. I'll give it to Carlius if he uses a shield.
The other two don't use shields.
My mom's just called me like 4 times in a row.
Alrighty. Carlius, do you use shields? Oh, he's AFK, that's right.
I look over at Carlius and he's just like staring into the distance.
Yeah, it's like the same way that all the NPCs see the Dovahkiin in Skyrim when you wait. Just stand there just staring at nothing for 8 hours. Your AC goes down by 1, Tobias, after that rest.
Ah, well. 17's still pretty good. AC's not really my problem. It's stuff that gets through and deals my whole health damage.
Yeah, you really gotta stick closer to me.
I'll keep that in mind next time we are chucked underwater and, like, digested.
I just mean in general. Just, like, stay within, like 15 feet. Like, within arm's reach.
Because
we always end up split up, and then the person who's meant to be defending the squishy gets preoccupied with not defending the squishy.
I will definitely keep that at the forefront of my mind going forward, because I do not want to experience this day ever again.
I should heal as well.
Tobias writes a note in one of his books to himself and like underlines it like 5 times to get some sort of emergency bailout spell or magic item or something to use when he can't talk. Because he is useless when he cannot talk, as these last 2 sessions have shown us.
Yeah, when I was making that, I didn't really think about having the need to talk to cast spells.
So it looked, to be fair, I didn't either.
I felt a lot less dangerous in my mind.
It's an interesting challenge.
Yeah.
I have returned.
Yeah, welcome back.
Have I.
Yeah, oh, fuck.
Yeah, I died.
So, anybody know where we are or how to get the heck out of here?
We are here.
I mean, it stands to reason we still wouldn't be too far from Archerton.
Well, I stand up. Well, actually, I have no idea, because I was unconscious during my short overwater flight before landing back in the ocean.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, I've just got my helmet tucked under my arm and I'm just looking out into what's in front of me. How well lit is this place?
Alright, so as you sort of look around, despite the fact that the map shows that there's light here, there is actually no light.
Yeah, I figured.
The only light comes from sort of outside where, like the water itself would be giving you a little bit of illumination in here. So like the walls are all that. You know how, like, in dark rooms and the water's there and it goes sparkly on the walls? Sort of cool. Like that.
Alright.
I assume my lamp, or the oil more specifically, is totally just wrecked.
Oh, yeah, completely wrecked.
Give it over here. You might not have any oil, but I can dry it out for you.
Sure, hand it over.
Alright, I'll just hold it in my hands and just warm it up, steam it. Make it dry.
I don't have any oil for it, though. Maybe. I assume that's all good.
Not if it was in a container.
Yeah, if it was in a container, it should be fine with your 11 roll.
Okie dokie.
Do you have a container of oil?
I didn't know one down. I have a pint or whatever it's called.
Is Thorin still covered in shit?
If you were, I would have bestowed the gage and cleaned you.
Thank you.
Because I do not want to share the airtight dome. It smell like that.
Fair enough.
Salt water shit.
So as everyone's sort of waking up from their rest and like taking in the sights around, you know that there's very little light in here, very dark, poorly illuminated, and the air smells really musty and I guess a little bit thin.
Fuck, I never picked my torch back up.
Don't you have like 3?
I had to get rid of them.
Hey, Longshore.
I left like 20 rations in the pile of treasure.
How's your bird going? Is it kind of looking like a bit woozy? Canary in a mineshaft type thing?
What's that?
Your bird, is it looking a bit woozy?
Oh, right. Is Razor dying?
Yeah. Like canary in a mineshaft type thing. Do we have to worry about suffocating?
That's actually going to be my other question. If you brought your bird down with you, there's a pretty good chance it died in the water. Not in this room, but like...
Oh, yeah, that's a good point. What's this constitution?
And before it's higher than you?
0. Yeah. Rip Razor.
Bias takes off his hat. As a moment of silence.
If you really want, I could resurrect it. That's why I wasn't too scared about Tobias dying, but it's a pretty rough process. It'll be pretty sick.
Do you need like several $1,000 of gems that we don't have?
No. I fish out my holy symbol that has a red glow. I said, remember, we all got a gift.
Oh, yeah.
Ah. Well, that's cool.
Yeah, I'm not spending 1,000 gold on your shitty bird, sorry.
And your bird sort of like Even though it's dead, it's like rigor mortis and everything, so its claws are still digging into your shoulder. And it just stood on your shoulder, but dead.
It's like a stuffed parrot. Onto my armor.
I can resurrect it if you want. It'll just be a little bit shitty.
How shitty?
Well, when I resurrect something, you roll 66. And so the first 6 is for strength, the second 6 is for dexterity, etc., etc. And whatever you roll gets chopped off those stats.
Ugh.
Yeah, so if...
Don't worry.
It's a rough process. Anyway. Yeah. That's why I was like, if Tobias dies, he's going to be so fucked when he gets back up.
Oh, God.
So just keep in mind, I can do that, but it's a heavy price that you have to pay.
Yeah, it's almost not worth it, to be honest.
Yeah.
Like, I think I'd rather just make a new character than potentially take 6 off all my stats.
If you took much more off my strength score, I might just die under my own weight.
He just collapses into his own chest cavity. Alrighty, boys, enough waffling around. We gotta move.
Can I do, like, an investigation or something and try and figure out what the way out is, like, looking at the tracks and stuff?
Well,
see if I can determine.
Yes, you can roll an investigation. You're from Lutheria, right? So you get advantage for that, too.
Oh, how far did we get thrown?
Really, really far.
Hundreds of feet. Like, I would honestly guess, like, probably over 1,000 feet. We're fucking super far away.
So you would recognize these train tracks and, like, the ruins in general as being sort of like a mine shaft that dwarves who would have worked in, like, Lutherian mines and whatnot would have worked on. And you know that... The tracks themselves sort of lead to where you guys were initially, and they just disappear. It's like the entrance either caved in or was overrun by water, you're not sure. But there's only one way out of here, which is the way you came.
Still worth looking around, honestly.
Do I know...
Oh, even though I've revealed the whole map, it doesn't mean you've actually checked everywhere.
Yeah.
I just figured it'd be easier if I revealed everything.
Yeah.
So these are Lutherian style mines?
Oh yeah.
Okay. I have a sneaking suspicion, but I'm going to keep that to myself for now. I just tell everyone that it looks like the only way out is the way we came.
Alright, as this is happening, I'm going to walk up to Tobias and shove the spear into his hands and be like, just fucking take it, man.
Tobias takes it and says, your point has been thoroughly made.
As soon as he says point, I give him finger guns.
Tobias.
Yeah, I
flat look.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Okay, may as well take a look about while we're here.
Yeah. Do we have any source of light?
If I still have some oil, I can light my lamp.
Your sopping wet lamp.
Thorin dried it out for me.
Oh, right.
Do we have anything that's combustible?
Well, Carlius.
Carlius is actually pretty flame retardant, actually.
Being yeah, a he's a tiefling.
He is retardant.
I walk over to, like... this rotten, collapsed wood here, and just, like, pry out a good-sized chunk and hand it to Thorin.
Can you?
Good point. Let's see. I make the attempt.
Athletic. Just, like, his fingers fold backwards.
yeah, you can roll strength at advantage.
Don't often get to roll strength at advantage. That's a 12.
Yeah, you're able to rip out a small chunk of wood. Enough to make a torch. It snaps off from the main support beam pretty easily.
I'll hand it to Thorin.
Alright, I'll spend a minute or two taking, like, my shoulder plate off and, like, ripping my sleeve off and then tying it around the end of the wood and putting my shoulder plate back on.
While they're doing that, can I see anything off in the distance, or...?
You don't notice any... for Longshaw, you don't notice anything out of the ordinary other than just, like, mine stuff, like crates and whatnot.
Alright, cool.
My god, this is gonna chafe so bad. And I roll my arm. How do I light this on fire? Oh wait, hold on, I've got an idea. I smash Carlius in the balls with it in the hopes that he rebukes the piece of wood and lights it on fire.
Fucking... Hang on, I can use thaumaturgy on it.
I can use thaumaturgy on it, that's just... I can use thaumaturgy on it, it's just way less fun.
Well, do it your damn self.
Fine. I just, like, rub my hands together and let the embers drop onto it.
Alright.
You're right, it wasn't fun.
It doesn't take too long before eventually the wood catches on fire, and it gives you about 15 feet of bright light.
And then, is it 15 feet beyond? Dim?
Yeah, 15 feet dim after that, yeah.
Alright. I'll just set that up real quick. There we go.
Okay. Split up and look for clues, gang.
Split up? Fuck you. It was good.
I'm gonna roll stealth and try and stay out of the light.
Jack.
Sure, roll your stealth.
My lamp.
Oh, did you find oil for it?
I said I had oil. Do I have oil, West?
Do you have oil? It's your inventory.
I had oil, but does it still exist after our trip through the wall?
If you have it in a container, not in your lamp, then yes. But if it's in your lamp, that would have been washed away.
Awesome. I have, like, a bit then, but not very much left.
Alright.
Let's try not to split up too much.
Yeah. This does look fairly small, so we should be able to shout.
Alright. I point my hammer at Tobias.
Is that to scale? Is it 200 feet across?
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay, let's stick together then.
Yeah.
I thought it was much smaller than that. No. Yeah. So...
I put my hammer at him and I say, arm's length.
Yeah.
And I start moving south.
So as you sort of start walking along, playing on the metal tracks and whatnot, you eventually come across to one of those, it's like a rotating thing to change the direction of where the cart would go. And all along the walls are several barrels and several, like, cart full of rocks. Not specific ores, just literal rocks.
Goodies.
Are there any picks?
No. There are no picks, and most of the wood here seem to be fairly mossy, if not rotten already. And inside the barrels you find several bits of rations that aren't... They don't seem to be edible at all. And there are also some cave mushrooms inside those...
Oof.
Barrels.
I immediately eat one.
Please no. Please don't make me use a fucking cure poison spell on you straight away.
I don't, actually.
Okay, good. I was gonna say, if we fucking burn a second level spell, like, 3 seconds after we wake up.
I think out of everyone, Aiden would know better than to eat a random fucking mushroom he found in a cave.
I know Aiden does, but Jacob might not.
Give me some credit.
I've seen you do some crazy shit. Remember that one time that you killed a bandit with your shit?
Yes.
Yeah. Alright, anyway, let's should we check these caved in bits? I assume they're caved in. I don't know, that's what we're gonna find out.
Those three paths would be where you came from. Like, they converge into the same room.
Oh.
Okay.
Do these bridges look stable?
Only one way to find out.
Actually, before you do, I'm going to check the traps.
That's probably a good idea.
Yeah, roll perception, please.
Perception.
You in Thailand.
You don't see any traps. Did notice that some various parts of the bridge have rotten wood on them.
Okay, just watch out for those couple of locks there, and I point them out.
Can I roll something to try and determine this thing's maximum, like, weight-bearing capacity? Just to make sure that me and my full plate and all my bullshit would just snap it.
Investigation.
Oh, I'm not very good at that. Oh, never mind.
It's going to be more than capable of carrying everyone, except for the bottom parts.
Alright, cool.
Hey Thorin, see those really dark bits of wood? Make sure you jump on those.
I was just thinking, I should probably jump both feet. Stomp as hard as I can.
Those are the only safe bits.
Hey Longshot, actually, do you want to scuttle ahead and be your sneaky self?
Scuttle.
And you as well, Carlius.
I'll have to roll stealth first. Should know better.
I chop the cables.
Oh, boom. Oh.
Damn.
Are you still even on the prime material plane?
I was going to say I'm probably airborne by this point.
Yeah. Carlius just fades into Shadowfell instantly.
You sort of move along the darkness that's inside this cave, and the both of you cross the bridge without any issue, and as you sort of look around, you don't actually see anything in particular, except for Longshore, who scouts up ahead. All along this wall are various minerals that are still unmined and stuck inside the wall.
Ooh, valuable minerals?
I don't know, are they?
Can I recognize?
No. You don't recognize them at all.
Can I roll something to recognize them?
That's a good question.
Am I able to roll something?
Let me just double check something.
Yeah.
Nature, perhaps?
No. Investigation Ooh. Would be great.
Investigation. Oh my god.
Manish is having a domestic.
Did you guys hear that too? Like, I'm just sitting here minding my own business, doing my own thing, and someone in the other room is screaming.
Yeah, we heard that.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of which, are you ready or not?
I'm just about ready, yeah.
Okay.
I'd completely forgotten you were here.
Oh, well, they are... These are pieces of wood.
Why have they dug all this out? There's nothing down here.
Longshore, you're able to... You know that these are definitely valuable ores, for sure. You're not sure what, but you know they're ores.
Guys, get some picks.
Why? What'd you find?
Just do it.
There are no picks. I looked around for some. Why? What did you find? I'm going to carefully navigate the bridge and make my way over to where Longshore is freaking out about.
I start clawing at the wall and trying to get the minerals.
This is totally my jam. Like, this is my fucking domain right here. So I'm gonna hold my makeshift torch up to it.
Alright. Thorin, you can roll an investigation at advantage. Everyone else who wants to, just do it at normal. Well, so I guess Tobias would be the only one. Other first. Carlius, you're not sure what they are.
Yeah, I reckon it would.
I'm so bad at investigation.
Thorin, you don't know what it is either.
Hey.
But Tobias, having spent many years in the university, you are able to determine that these are actual mithril chunks.
Ooh.
Yeah,
I've never seen blue metal before.
I say mithril.
Wow.
Tobias, you better fucking jot this shit down. We're coming back here.
Can't you just use your hammer to smash it out of the wall?
My hammer isn't technically magical, like, it's not a plus one, it's just got, like a fake sort of, like, enchanted core, and so it'll break if I do that.
Not if you do.
If it was a magical weapon, I'd go to town, but I don't want to fuck my hammer up.
I'm gonna try, using one of my daggers, because I've got three of the fuckers, I'm gonna try and dig around, see if I can get any of it out.
Yeah, sure, roll your strength at advantage.
What if you use Callius as a battering ram?
I'll go see if I can find a pickaxe somewhere. I'm just gonna
I'm gonna go do that
check
too.
Out down here.
Hey!
Alright, Callius, you fully blunt this dagger, even though you're digging around the mithril, so it's gonna take... As you do that, a small little chunk of mithril comes out of the wall, with like bits of dirty rock stuck around it.
Okay. I... Hand it over to Thorin.
I'm off looking for picks, but I'll be back in a second.
Oh, okay.
As you sort of start looking around, you see in those crates that are down in the room that you're currently in, they have various, like, minor clothes and whatnot and shoes. You guys do come across four iron pickaxes that are very rusted.
That's fine.
And, like, the wood of the handle itself is, like, rotten as well, so...
Either way, I'm gonna, like, put my fingers to my lips and There's some fucking picks down here.
Can you fix them? They're kind of shitty.
I can unrust them, but I can't fix the wood.
Well, we look like the only... It looks like we're the only ones who've been down here in a long time. So, if we can get out of here and get our bearings, I'll make sure to note down where this is. We can come back better equipped.
Yeah, it's absolutely worth revisiting, but I don't know if it's on the top of our priorities right now.
Yeah, it was maybe kind of an apocalypse to...
Well, not even before then, I just want to go out and get geared up, get some more potions, talk to Kyra once again, see how my parents are doing.
Is this path here, or is this button?
Oh, no. I just didn't reveal it, because it's the squares. Yeah, just a dead end.
Okay.
So, I hand over the small piece of metal and say, here you go, Thorin.
Oh, sweet. Cool. I turn it over my hands. Can I check the purity of this thing? Is it like...
It's a very small chunk.
Like, yeah, I imagine it's like a size of like a $2 coin.
Yeah.
So is it ore, or is it just like a vein of metal?
I don't know the difference.
Well, is it just like metal in the rock, or would we...
Yeah, it's just metal in the rock.
Melted.
Yeah, or it's like we would have to smelt it down and refine it. And if there's a vein, you can just literally mine it out of the wall.
Oh, okay, then vein.
It's, okay. They're usually an oxide.
Alright, still don't know the difference. But if you're going to start mining this, I'm just going to tell you this out of character, because I don't know how to explain it, because ore doesn't talk. You can estimate that it's going to take about 6 hours of mining to fully mine this entire mithril vein.
Oh yeah, for sure, we'll come back later.
So, let's get out of here.
Yeah. Just want to be sure that there's no, other entrances. I'm just going to, do a circuit of the place, just running my fingers along the wall.
Yeah, no, you do that, but you come up with nothing still.
Alright, worth a try. Alright, boys, I think we go out the way we came.
Okay.
I ride Thorin like a horse.
I put him on my shoulders like a child.
Whee!
Alright, yeah. I guess we go back outside.
So this water down here, that's not the stuff we climbed, right?
No, but you can assume that it leads to it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
Well, I saw a bridge on the other side out in that room. Maybe we could check out there.
No, yeah, that's what led to this. The other bridge would... take you from down here, like the bottom part.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You go out and need to have to fight the shark again.
Alrighty. So, everyone going back?
Yeah.
Okay.
Then, hopefully if the shark's there, Longshore can just snipe it from up on the ledge.
Yeah, I'll jump down in the water and have it come up to the surface, and then you can just poke at it and I'll just heal myself afterwards.
What if we just tied Carlius up, gave him a little Ling Chi, and then threw him down?
What about if you go fuck yourself?
I mean, either way is good.
I'm gonna, hand around the torch and put it out.
Yeah, I doused my lamp.
I'm just gonna take a sec. Manish, are you ready, or did you wanna
join?
Yeah,
I'm ready.
Or are you gonna just watch?
Oh, no, I'm good to join at this point, I think.
Okay, did you have a token in mind?
No, just choose a random wizard token. It's fine.
Yeah, wizard.
Yeah.
You're a wizard, honey.
That's literally the one thing that could possibly augment this party even more than it already is. Is an int-based character. We've got wisdom, we've got constitution... Oh, not constitution. We've got wisdom, we've got two physicals, we've got a charisma, and then we've got intelligence. Oh, yeah!
Whee!
Just give me a sec to find you a token. I'm just going to put a random one on just for now.
He falls through the ceiling and lands in the shark's mouth. The end.
What's your character called?
Arcturus Flick.
It's a cool name.
What does it start with?
Arcturus.
Alright, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. You get nicknamed so fucking fast?
What was that?
I said you're getting nicknamed so fucking fast.
there's a lot of bass in my microphone, so I'm not sure what you're saying, but okay. Showing folder. Why is this in the shit posting folder? Whatever.
Alright, so I was actually gonna, do you mind if I could just go back to the other room, because I don't know if he was ready on, and I was gonna put him in the other room, but then he was like,
yeah, it's all good, we can recon.
Alright, backflip into the other room.
Alright, so as you guys are sort of like to the right hand side inspecting like the mithril ore and whatnot, everyone sort of hears a very loud bang originating from those mithril ores in the wall, and as the room sort of, the walls collapse, you see this one wizardly looking dude inside.
Oh god!
Holy shit.
And like just bits and pieces of mithril on the floor and whatnot.
Oh dear. Hello, good gentleman.
I draw my weapon.
Excuse me, young scallywag, don't draw your weapon at me. Put that away. You could hurt someone. Take someone's eye out.
Poppycock, yeah, take someone's eye out with my hammer.
Well, I mean, I've seen one go flying before. Remember that guy who was hanging from the tree?
Yeah, I bow my head a little bit.
Is that a hammer? Looks like a sword from here. He says, squinting, looking at you. He's got glasses on, big glasses. They're completely clouded with, like, dirt.
Yes.
I walk up to him, take the glasses off, clean the glasses and give it back to him. Try now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, young man. I pat him on the shoulder. It's a dude, right? Like,
yes, it is.
Okay. I pat him on the shoulder. Thank you, young man. Thank you.
I take his glasses, spit on the ground, rub them in the mud, and then put them back on his face.
Let's see. What am I, chaotic neutral? Yeah, no, I think this is fine.
Oh, yeah, and like bits and pieces of mithril all over the place.
I don't even make eye contact. We fucking scoop that shit up.
Tobias, as the apparently only socially competent person in the party, steps forward.
Party face, bud. I'm busy.
Thorin, could you roll Actually, everyone roll a 1d20, except for Flick. Actually, Flick, you too.
Okay.
No!
Jesus.
I'll change my token over in a sec, hang on.
Fire
out. My fucking soul hurts.
Like, Thorin and Longshaw bend over to pick up the same piece of mithril at the same time and just like head get knocked out.
Yeah, somehow through my helmet.
How much acid damage do I take this time?
So, you find 5 pounds of mithril, which is a crap ton, and I'm just going to go from the top to the bottom, Tobias, as you're picking, wait, you weren't picking through it, were you?
No.
Ah. As you're walking up towards Flick, you sort of kick over 2 small rocks on the floor. As you look down, they sort of pop out at you, and you realize that they're 2 very fine rubies. Very pristine condition, and you would know that they're worth about 100 gold each.
Neat. I'll take a moment to just scoop them up and shove them in a pocket.
Sorry, Cass.
Mr. GM, sir, this place is it a mine? Like, what is this place?
I'll get to that in a second.
Oh, okay. Well, I'd like to pull a this. How do I do that? That.
Alright. Give me a sec. Because we got some nat ones. could Thorin and Aiden please roll a 1d... it's not a 1d20. Constitution.
The one thing I'm not good at...
You'll get knocked the fuck out! I'm headbutting your nose into the back of your skull.
Oh!
You are so fucked! I'm gonna fucking run you over somehow.
So the initial explosion of Flick sort of appearing there and breaking the walls apart, not only do chunks of rock go flying, but also very, poisonous gas starts to fill the room. Immediately, Longshaw is clocked in the face by a large boulder pinning you to the wall, dealing 30 points of damage.
Oh, holy shit!
And you're immediately pinned to the wall. You are currently restrained by a boulder.
Guys!
And I'm going to
And Carlos,
go.
Roll a constitution save.
Oh, no.
Yes, you do. You have a 3.
Damn it.
Really glad I lucked out on that constitution.
As for throwing, you're able to duck behind your shield, and most of the rocks and pebbles, sorry, rolling that one, sort of pings off your shield. But you and Longshore do both get poisoned by something. You don't know what yet. Carlos, you're okay then.
Poison. So I can recognize that I'm poisoned, right?
Yeah, you immediately feel it. Like, as soon as you breathe in the gas, it immediately starts to burn your lungs.
Fucking god damn it. Well, now this is happening.
Thank you, sir.
Two fucking spell slots gone. Oh, well. I guess it's the price you pay for a nat one.
Can someone get this rock out of my ribcage, please?
Yeah, how is he pinned to the wall exactly? Is it, like, wrapped around him, or is it, like...
So it's just, like, a big round boulder that smashed him in the ribcage, pinning him to the wall, and then it fell down onto his legs. And he's just sitting down in, like, a corner with a big rock on him.
Alright, I'm gonna try and push this thing.
To push it off.
Yeah, I'm gonna assist.
So, just double-checking, do I take any damage from the con save, or...?
You do not. Carlos, you're okay.
Okay, sweet. So I helped to get rid of the rock as well.
Alright. Oh yeah, that's more than plenty. Like, you just roll it off to the bad side of Longshore where the leg's already crushed so it doesn't hurt anymore. And he just rolls off and then the boulder goes away. And Longshore's okay on the floor with a broken thigh. And a crushed
leg. I'm gonna crouch down and do some combat triage on him.
In fact, being unable to breathe, the poison doesn't affect you much either.
I look at the wizard, I'm just like, the fuck?
I'm sorry about that, gentlemen. I thought you saw the boulder coming.
Alright, I'm just going to take this one heal at a time, so I'm going to rub my hands together like a defibrillator and then put them on his chest. That's nice.
And for Flick, you'd understand that this used to be a mine that was run by the dwarves that would operate from Lutheria.
Oh, that's awesome. Is there any dwarvish writing around anywhere, or is it just... Okay.
It's not like a dwarven hold or anything, it's just a mine.
Okay.
It's like in and out and done.
Would you like another one?
I wouldn't mind.
All right. I was going to say, I'll give him a potion of healing as well so you're not burning your spell slots.
No, because my spell slots come back.
Yeah, those potions are really handy.
That's true. It's one of the lesser ones. It's not the bigger ones.
Either way, I put the first one in his chest and the second one on his leg.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
I clamber to my feet and deathglare the wizard. Where the fuck did you come from?
Yeah, I like give him like a Beastmaster arm clasp and pull him to his feet.
As we're all starting to interrogate Flick, sorry for interrupting. You do know that the room starts to fill with the gas.
Yeah, I'm prestidigitating a wind to push away the cloud of noxious gases.
Just it seems to continue filling the room.
Oh, yeah. Shit. Okay.
It's time to fucking go.
We should talk later and skedaddle.
Get the fuck out. Yeah.
So, did you say to me that because...
Hold on. I grabbed this last bit of mithril. I hold my breath as I walk in.
Was it you were saying that because I got winded by the thing, I didn't inhale any of the gas?
I cured the poison anyway.
Yeah, you cured.
Oh, okay.
I was just making a joke.
Oh, right.
Otherwise, I'd be like, oh, you can't breathe.
You're dead.
Alright, so everyone sort of goes back towards the other place.
Before the wizard walks across the bridge, I'll, like, stop him and point out the rotten boards that we found before so he doesn't fall into the water.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you. Okay.
I throw a rock at his fucking face.
Whoop. Right. I'll just move everyone again.
Yep.
Can you do the attention grabby thing?
Yeah, I will. Just a
second. Is it just me or did the world just end?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, guys, we fucking moved too slow. That's it. GG.
Alright, so as you all leave the mine area, you sort of come back to the same waterfall area that goes down to where you came from. Looking down, you don't see any sign of the shark or whatnot.
That has been, like, a full night. Can we ascertain the time of day?
Looking down into it, you would know that it's somewhere in the morning. Just judging by how hungry you were earlier as well.
Alright.
Did anyone see any dry land before when we were outside? I was unconscious for that part of the journey.
It was all underwater. We've all got our rings on now, though, I think.
Yeah.
Speak for yourselves.
Are you guys chatting about this aloud, or are you on...
Yeah, no, it's safe to assume that everything we say is in character.
Okay.
Why did you not attune your ring, Collius?
I didn't think I had a ring.
We've all got a ring of swimming.
We've all got rings.
Oh, okay, sweet.
Yeah, there was four.
Did you add the money from the loot pile before as well, Collius?
I'm pretty sure I added the money from end of last week, but I didn't add the ring. Yeah.
Right. There were four rings of swimming, so it's safe to assume.
Oh, there you go.
Fair enough. This water is much less scary.
You say that, but I saw the size of that shark.
Hey man, I can swing my Warhammer underwater now. I think I'm going to be alright.
If I activate my boots of water walking when I'm underwater, will I just shoot to the surface? Like,
no. It has no effect.
The idea that he just immediately spins upside down and just launched through the surface of the water.
I think I wrote it in the thing, but when you activate your boots of water walking, you have to be on land. And then you walk onto the water, and if you run or take any other action, you sink. And it deactivates.
Yeah, no, I'm just joking.
Oh, okay. Sorry for being a party pooper.
Is that poison still creeping towards us?
No. It's sort of centralized in that mine area.
Okay.
I put my torch out again.
Yeah. Now that we've got some space room, let's be polite, and I look significantly at Longshore,
I look up from picking my teeth with my long sword, like...
and I turn to this wizard and say, right, well, that was hectic. Starting off from the top, Tobias Black, and I put out a handshake.
Oh, nice to meet you, Mr. Black. I am Arcturus Flick of the College of Nearby Land. I don't actually know...
We might actually be colleagues then. Would he be from,
Yeah, he would be from Lutheria for sure.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, hey, Manish, could you also change your name to your character's name in the bottom?
What?
At the underneath bottom of your chat box. Yeah.
Like that?
Oh, yeah. It's already been done.
No, not the chat box. The other one.
Oh, right, yep.
Yeah. That'd be great. That'd help me out.
Yeah.
But yeah, you would be from Lutheria if you're a mage. With a filthy mage.
So is there a reason you tried to kill us all?
What?
Exploding the wall and filling the room with poison?
Oh!
Nice trick.
Oh, right, young man. You misunderstand. I was simply looking for a dwarven artifact. Hundreds of years old. Rumor has it was located in these mines, but... no luck. And of course, what happened was, we were all there, right? You're not quite so senile as me.
I poke up the mention of a dwarven artifact. I say, which one in particular?
You know, I can't quite remember. I'm just getting old these days.
Oh my god.
Human, elven? Like, what is...
I'm human.
Right.
Yeah.
How old are you? I can put an image to it.
Like 50s, 60s. Not that old, but like, yeah. I'm putting it on. It's pretty obvious. Yeah.
Well, do you know a way out of these mines that don't involve, and I point down into the water, swimming through the shark-infested waters?
I must confess, I am hopelessly lost. I pull out my cartographer's tools, I look at, you know, the map that I've drawn, and I show it to you, and it's just squiggly lines. They're completely indecipherable.
Well, damn, I was really hoping I wouldn't have to go swimming again. Or ever again.
I was just going to say, are you able to do Liam and hut as like a swimming cage sort of thing?
No, it doesn't move, unfortunately.
And it takes like 10 minutes to cast.
Carly used to look at chat.
I
hand, yep. Wait.
Actually, something that Arcturus said is just kind of twigged with Tobias. He said he's Lutheria. Tobias says, I'm from the College of Demon's Reach, which I assume is where you hail from as well. What are you doing out so far from Lutheria?
I am looking for the long lost city of
L6.
Well, it's a cursed city, okay? You learn about it, you can't remember the name. It's a dwarven city, I can't remember the name. Looking for an artifact. Okay, well, yes, you get the idea. I'm an archaeologist.
Oh yeah, out of character for Tobias. Oh, actually, out of character for Eric. He literally just joined, like, today. No previous talk or anything, he just popped
yeah,
in.
Yeah, I have no idea about the world. Asking me questions about the world is like, I'm just ad-libbing, like, because I have no fucking idea what's going on, so yeah.
All right. Okay. Hey, Mr. DM, I've rolled that 21 for unfucking Carlius's dagger, but I'm just going to assume that take a piss, so I'm just, like, zoned out just doing that.
Oh yeah, sure. That's a pretty good roll, actually. You're able to unfuck it to a -1 instead of a -2. If you want to roll again, just to see.
Yeah, I'll roll again.
Anything under a 10.
Oh, nice!
You improve it.
You restore it to its former glory.
Can I etch my signature into the blade?
Yes, you can.
And it's all cursive and fancy.
Could Carlius, when you add that dagger to your inventory, can you make a note of that?
That it's engraved.
Yeah. Whatever Thorin wants to say. What do you engrave?
I was just going to engrave it with my signature.
Alright. Just write it as Ward Dagger.
Yeah. No, you call it the Warded Dagger. Alright, so I'm going to go take a piss. We'll be back in a bit. Mm-hmm.
So, out of character, I'm asking what Arcturus is doing so far away from Lutheria. Are we actually that far away from Lutheria? Because I don't think Tobias has twigged that we may have travelled much further than we did.
This is out of character?
Yeah, just so...
No, you're still in L6, for sure.
Okay, yeah. So that question wouldn't be weird for him. We are actually quite weird.
Yeah, quite far away from Lutheria, for sure.
Okay. I was thinking we had, like... an avatar situation where the lion turtle.
I was gonna say to Arcturus Flick out of character and message him. I forgot. I was gonna just say he came here either via teleportation gone wrong, not him casting teleportation, but someone else casting it for him.
Mm-hmm. Well, that ties innately with us exploring an old dwarven ruin sort of thing. Mm-hmm.
So that's why he ended up inside a wall instead of outside. And then just all the energy that are charged from like the teleportation itself just ruptured the gas vein, exploded everything, almost killed one of you. And here we are today.
I'm almost dying a lot lately.
Tobias gives you a sympathetic, empathetic nod.